AI is ushering in the age of the augmented workforce.
With AI, we are solving complex problems at a much faster rate. It's working 24/7 for us, and that's where you drive value.
Given the uncertainty and complexity in today's world, AI agents can significantly help to improve and close that gap.
How do you get all of the fundamentals in place to ensure that you can actually drive that ROI and capture the value? You know, do the right AI and do AI right. When you look at the leading companies, they are, they focus on 40% fewer use cases, but driving 2x more ROI, right? While when you look at sort of the lower cohort, they're not focusing, right? And it's too broad, and hence they don't get the ROI.
HR is a great candidate for AI adoption, very simply because it is transaction rich. So the automation that you can achieve through AI will actually be able to help take out an enormous amount of work from the HR professionals that are doing that on a day-to-day basis. Agentic AI can be supremely helpful in being able to not only understand what the skills are that you have within your organization, but also build the future job roles that you need, and then eventually continue to evolve those as the organization and the enterprise evolves as well.
CFOs by nature, they're going to be a little bit risk averse and thinking about control. So it's a matter of how do you maintain control and risk while you're also being an agent of transformation. It's not just about agentic or generative or what's the next big word, but it's really combining AI, machine learning, automation, everything together. And that's what's eventually going to create this autonomous agent that's able to act. And that's really what's going to help with that forecasting accuracy, is getting to better insights, better data. And if you get to insights faster, then CFOs can make decisions faster.
So in supply chains, like, there's so much happening. There's so many data points. There's so many decisions and personas kind of coming together to make a decision. Human brains can process a lot of things, but when it comes to a lot of disparate data, it still needs time to consume that. AI brings a lot of that automatically to us, where we can create scenarios for all these type of disruptions. And they can come from any side, right? They can come from some disturbed region. They can come from a shortage in a place. They can come from some weather event. Now, the beauty is that how soon we can do simulations around these events and understand the impact of them. Maybe for some disruptions, we don't even have to react towards them. But the sooner, the better we understand the impact of them, the improved decisions we can make, and it will help our business grow.
So how do you scale AI, right? Because, you know, lots of experimentation, lots of POCs have happened over the last couple of years. But the real way to ensure that you are getting value and you're scaling is to ensure that you have a few sort of fundamental things in place. You want to make sure that you have the right governance in place, right? Both organizational governance and the technical AI governance that is required to scale your AI initiatives.
There's never been a more important time for change management in the digital transformations that enterprises are undertaking. We really need to be making sure that we're looking at it from the very beginning and understanding who exactly the personas are that we're dealing with, who will be the users of the outcome and the solution that we're trying to achieve, understanding the impact to them, understanding what skills they have and don't have that they will need in the future, closing those gaps through the actual development tasks that actually address those ideas.
Make sure that you're continuously, validating and monitoring the value capture, right?
We also need to measure how the decisions done by AI or the agents are in compared to the actuals, what has really happened. So we need to do those comparisons, and then only we can determine and find, we need to adjust these guardrails so that these decisions can become more and more accurate as we go forward.
So why is IBM special in helping clients adopt and scale AI? We are bringing the best technology solutions for our clients based on their needs and their environments. I think that makes us really unique amongst our peers.
Because of the work that we're doing as Client Zero, we're able to bring those insights that what we've learned from our own transformation and bring it to our clients.
Because we have parallels that we can draw very clearly, you know, since we understand our clients' businesses, you know, fairly well, right? We can walk in and say, this is the size of the prize for you. You know, in a number of ways, we can bring the learnings that of what we've done internally to our clients, right? And help them on their own transformation.